AR, also known as augmented reality, is a technology that superimposes a computer-generated image on a user's view of the real world, thus providing a composite view, according to the dictionary. Although you may not know it, AR is everywhere. AR was used heavily in Pokemon Go, a game where Pokemon can be captured in the real world. Advertisements like Maybelline L'Oreal's nail polish harnessed AR to give users a unique opportunity to virtually try on new colors. In 2013, Volkswagen released an app called Marta for technicians to seek assistance when servicing a car. AR is really cool and works like magic, but how was it originally created? Well, that's what we're gonna talk about today. The first display of augmented reality was in 1966, 8 years before the release of Star Trek. Ivan Sutherland made a headset allowing viewers to see a cube floating in the real world. The head-mounted display was named the Sword of Damocles because the sword, in Roman myths, can be suspended in midair without dropping, just like the cube floating in midair. The system consisted of 6 subsystems: a matrix multiplier, a clipping divider, a vector generator, headset, head position sensor, and a computer. The matrix multiplier was used to map out the cube in midair. The clipping divider was used to clip the headset onto his head. The vector generator projected the image. The headset is obviously what he wore. The head position sensor sensed the position of Ivan's head and moved the cube accordingly. Lastly, a computer was used for other miscellaneous stuff. But what does this all mean for us? What's the next step of augmented reality? Well, in July 2017, Apple just announced that they were going to jump into AR. For iOS 11, the next iOS update, Apple will have a feature called arkit. You can basically place things virtually around the world. For example, you could use the app and place down a Pokemon on your desk, and when someone else uses the app, that person can also see the Pokemon. You can also draw and write things in 3D that can float in midair, or place down a moving zombie, and much more. This is a big step into the AR world, and AR is finally going to be something that everyone uses. The future with AR is also super amazing. If we continue using AR in the near future, we can enter a hyperreality. The problem with the digital age we are in now is that electronics can be bad for our health, but if things were put in the real world instead of on tablets and devices, it might not be as bad for us. Here's a short clip by Kaichi Matsuda about what the future may look like. The world may become half reality and half virtual. People will be adding tons of things onto the real world that would make the world look completely different. This may be what the near future would look like, whether you like it or not. Although right now AR is not used as much, Apple's AR kit might just enter our world into a new hyper reality. Guys, thanks so much for watching this video. We hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to give us a big sloppy like. If you want more content like this, hurry up and subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss anything. Bye!